Good morning, dear students. So, we were discussing about the chapter genetics. We have already learned about the previous part of this chapter, and today we will be continuing with the Mendel's experiment. What does Mendel did, and what are the things that we found here, and why is he known as the father of genetics? Okay, so we have done something over here. I will be discussing this entire part, but before that, please open your book. That is Conscience Biology class 10 and page number 30. We will be following the book so that we can understand this chapter better and clearly. Okay, so Mendel's experiment on inheritance. The basic principle of genetics was discovered for the first time by Gregor John Mendel in the mid of 19th century. Mendel was an Australian monk and he conducted breeding experiment on garden pea. Okay, now why garden pea? Why not any other type of pea? That we will also learn over here. Mendel was the Australian monk and he conducted breeding experiment on garden pea out of sheer interest. His finding became a milestone in biology. Okay. Now Mendel has selected garden pea for the following reasons. So what are the reasons for selecting this garden pea? Okay. The first one is many varieties were available in the alternative forms of a character. So availability, the first one is the availability of the particular plant. Second one, varieties were available in pure forms that breed true, that is produce the same type of generation after generation. Okay, now see, alternative forms was also available, or alternative form is also available. Along with that, pure form is also available. Peas are normally self-pollinated, but self-pollination could be prevented by removing corresponding reproductive part, male part stamen and the female part carpel of the flower, and could be as well as cross-pollinated. So we can stop the self-pollination as well as we can do cross-pollination of this particular plant as well. The lifespan of pea plant is short and many generations can be obtained and started in less time. Okay, so if we take a plant, suppose which gives a life generation of 100 years, then how would we going to study the next generation of that particular plant? We itself will not be there, right? So the Mendel took garden pea plant. Mendel took varieties of pea plants showing 7 pairs of contrasting features as shown in figure 3.6. Mendel crossed pure breeding varieties first by taking only one feature at a time, that is monohybrid cross, and then by taking two features together, that is dihybrid cross. He tried with all the 7 features of his observation were similar for all of them. So what are the characteristics we have got? Just look into figure 3.6 or page number 30, we'll be finding that flower color, it is purple and white. Dominant is purple, recessive is white. Seed color, dominant is yellow, recessive is green. Seed shape, round and wrinkled. Pod color, green yellow. Pod shape, inflated constricted. Flower position, axillary terminal. Plant height, tall and dwarf. Okay, now for the case 1 that we are going to study from here, you can follow your book or you can simply look on what I am trying to teach you. Okay, it is very easy, you just need to understand. So what actually Mendel took? But before that, I would like you all to look into this particular diagram, whatever I have done in the board, once. After that, I will be continuing explaining what this particular genetics or what this particular chapter, this thing is all about. Now, what Mendel did is that he took two plant. Okay, he took two plant. One is this terminal flower, the plant which is having terminal flower. Another one is the plant which is having axillary flower. Okay, now he cross-pollinated this terminal flower along with this axillary flower. Okay, now when he cross-pollinated, see, this terminal flower is having a gene type of AA. Okay, as it is terminal, and axillary flower is having AA. Okay, this we have already learned what is this capital and small one in our previous video lecture. So here we have found that terminal flower is AA and axillary flower is this capital, both the capital A's. Now he have cross pollinated both of this terminal flower along with the axillary flower. What he got is the first hybrid generation. Okay, he got the first hybrid generation, and here he have found that the plant is bearing all the axillary flowers. The particular plant crossed between terminal flower and axillary flower have got all the axillary flowers in the first hybrid generation, or in the first generation what he have done. There we found that the trait is AA, one is capital A, another one is small a. Okay. Now what he have done is that he have cross-pollinated. Please listen here carefully. He have cross-pollinated between these axillary flowers which is bearing one capital A and one small a. Okay. Now when he cross-pollinated among this terminal, with this terminal flower with the axillary flower, he have got all axillary flower bearing capital A and small a. Now he have self-pollinated. When he have self-pollinated between this particular flower, he found that there is three axillary flower, that he got three axillary flower plant bearing axillary flower, and one he got terminal flower. Okay, so see, this one is in the first hybrid generation and this one is in the second hybrid generation. Now then what we can conclude from it? See, on the second hybrid generation itself, we have found one terminal flower which came from the first hybrid generation or from the parents. So we can say that this particular AA characteristic, small AA characteristics, is inherited by this in the F2 hybrid generation. So this thing he have done, and he got that this terminal flower and this axillary flower, when they are cross-pollinated between each other, the result termed to be a all axillary flower in the particular plant, and that is one capital A and one small a. Now after that, when he have self-pollinated between these all axillary flowers, he have got that three axillary flowers, axillary bearing flower plant, and one terminal bearing flower plant. From here, see, if we only see on this, or only look into this F1 hybrid, then we will be found these all are axillary flowers, but when we have cross self-pollinated, we found a one terminal flower came. So this one terminal flower is actually nothing but an inherited character of this particular terminal flower from the parent itself. So I hope this one is clear to you all. Please look into it once. For any of the queries relating to this Mendel's experiment on inheritance case 1, please do ask me. And he have took this garden pea plant. Okay, he have took this garden pea plant. See, this axillary flower came from here. Okay, so this is what Mendel's did. The kind of ratio obtained by crossing for two different traits of a single character is known as monohybrid ratio. This consisted of the following: phenotype. So if we write the thing, that is what we have found, I'm just rubbing this part so that it is visible to you. Phenotype. What is phenotype? And what is genotypic ratio? See, phenotypic ratio here is the thing that we see, right? Phenotypic ratio is the one that we see. And in phenotypic ratio, what we are finding? We are finding 3:1, because 3 is axillary one and 1 is terminal. So we will be getting here 3:1. But in genotypic ratio, that is gene features ratio, what we are getting? We are getting 1:2:1. Why 1:2:1? Because 1 double A, to here, see, we are getting here this one, 1 AA, 2 small, 1 A and 1 a, and 1 this only small a. So this is known as genotypic ratio and this is known as phenotypic ratio. I am repeating once again, what is phenotypic ratio and what is genotypic ratio? Phenotypic ratio is the thing what is visible in front of us or what we see, right? What we look into. So looking on this particular F2 hybrid generation, we found that there is 3 axillary and 1 terminal. So the phenotypic ratio would be 3:1. But when we will be looking into the genes or into the genotypic ratio, we will find that here we have one, both the capital A's. See, 1:2, we have 2, 1 A and 1 a, that is 2, and another one is this one, both the small a's, and this is 1:2:1. So this is what happened in case 1. I hope this entire thing is clear. For at least 1 minute, please look into this particular thing so that we can continue with the next part of this chapter. Also, see, it is very easy if you understand it, and if you think of just mugging it up and writing it in the exam, then my dear student, I'm very sorry to say, it is not at all easy. You need to make your concept clear, you need to make it learn, you need to make it understand, and then only you can go through this particular chapter. Not only through this particular chapter, through any of the science chapter. Okay, your logic should be clear. Okay, so look into this. For any of the problem, do text me or ask me. I'll be happy to help you guys. Okay, so this is the entire thing. Now we'll be going to the case 2. What is case 2? Case 2 is the same thing. He have taken pure tall TTP plant, were crossed with dwarf TT plants, and the progeny was the same. The same thing happened here in turn of terminal and axillary. He have took one pure tall and one with dwarf plant. Okay, pure dwarf plant. And then in the third case, what he have taken? He have taken one round and one wrinkled. Okay, so the same thing is seen. Phenotypic ratio of 3:1 and genotypic ratio of 1:2:1. Some of the generalized principle based on the above breeding experiment were as follow. Each pair of contrasting character depend on a pair of gene. Each individual carries such genes in duplicate. An individual produces gamete sex cell which have only one member of a pair of genes. Fertilization of the gametes restores the duplicate conditions of the genes, and sex cell with respect to the genes they contain get fertilized at random. Okay. Now what is dihybrid ratio? Dihybrid ratio is that gives us the breeding result with two pairs of contrasting characters. Now see, here what you have done is a monohybrid ratio. Okay, here only one pair of contrasting character is there, one terminal flower and one axillary flower. But here after that we will be getting a dihybrid cross. In dihybrid cross, we will be taking two contrasting pair of characters at a once. Now, what we will be getting in the monohybrid ratio, in F2 generation, we will be getting phenotypic ratio as 3:1, genotypic ratio as 1:2:1. But in dihybrid ratio, we will be getting, if we do this, it is a homework for you all, you just go through it, we will be getting phenotypic ratio for dihybrid will be 9:3:3:1, and this genotypic ratio for dihybrid will be very complex. Okay, this would be very complex. Now these both the things are for dihybrid. And this thing is for monohybrid. Okay. So you just go through this particular thing once, and we'll be going to the Mendel's laws of inheritance. So what are the laws that he have proposed? Okay. Mendel's generalization of the result of breeding experiment are summarized under three laws. We have got three laws. Please learn this very well, this particular three laws. It is very important for your exam. Laws of dominance. Out of a pair of contrasting characters present together, only one is able to express itself while the other remains suppressed. The one that expresses is the dominant character, and the one unexpressed is the recessive. The recessive character can express only when the pair of consisting of both recessive or homozygous recessive. So we already know that when both will be recessive, then only this recessive character or trait can be expressed. Otherwise, it will remain suppressed. Okay. Laws of segregation, also called laws of purity of gametes. The two members of a pair of factors separate during the formation of gamete. They do not blend but segregate or separate into different gametes. The gametes combine together by random fusion at the time of zygote formation. The third one is laws of independent assortment. When there are two pairs of characters, the distribution of the alleles of one character into the gamete is independent of the distribution of the alleles of the other character, as seen in the production of the gametes of F1 hybrid and dihybrid cross that we have already seen. Now, what is the application of Mendel's law? See, direct questions are going to come from here. State the Mendel's laws of inheritance. Okay. Or what are the applications of Mendel's law? You need to write this. Application of Mendel's law. A knowledge on the basis of Mendelian principle gives us an idea about the new combination in the presence of hybrid and enables us to predict their frequency. See, we can predict what is going to happen in the next generation or in the third generation or in the fourth generation. We can have a prediction of that. Number two, such information is of great importance to both plant and animal breeders for producing better breeds. Okay. Number three, new type of plants with new combinations of useful characters can be produced by hybridization. We can produce new characters of the plant. Now, what is mutation? Mutation is a sudden change in one or more genes, or in the number or in the structure of the chromosome. Now, if there is a sudden change in the structure of chromosome or number of chromosome or any one of the part, then we term that as mutation. Okay. Mutation alters the hereditary material of an organism cells and result in a change in certain characters or trait. For example, sickle cell anemia is a blood disease caused by gene mutation. The mutation causes change in the DNA resulting in the production of sickle-shaped RBC. Radioactive radiation also alter the gene structure, and their effect can be seen generation after generation. An atomic explosion which had occurred during World War II in 1945 in Japan, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, we all know about that, has led to a number of deformities in the body of a plant and animal which are still persisting. So, this completes your chapter of genetics. I hope this chapter, up till from where I have started, from the starting of this chapter with the three video lectures, it is complete clear to you all. Please go through these video lectures of numerous time as you want, as this is online mode. You can always play it, you can always study about opening this one. It is available in your class, it is available in YouTube. But please go through this for a number of times. You will be finding this chapter very interesting and very easy. And also, as I've already told in my previous first lecture, that if you find yourself interested in this particular chapter, genetics, you can study it after your 10 plus 2 or after your 12 examination. You can go for genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is a name, but actually it is a BSc course, that is a Bachelor of Science course. You can go through it. It is having a lot of perspectives in our current situation and current generation. Also, please go through this particular chapter very carefully, very attentively, opening your book in front of you and your biology copy. Make notes of whatever I have done in the board or whatever I have made you understand. Go through it. I hope everything is clear. For any of the doubts, please do feel free to ask me. And take care of yourself, take care of your family. Global pandemic is going outside. Stay home, stay safe. take care of everyone around you and stay safe. Okay, study hard. Thank you.